I came to the land of milk and honey to drain the swamps and work the land. But I'm not doing my pioneering work where you might expect. I'm doing it in my new stem cell research laboratory at Tel Aviv University. My name is Yechiel Elkabetz, and I'm a graduate of Tel Aviv University. After my postdoc training at Sloan Kettering in New York, I returned here with a dream of discovering a novel type of stem cell in the nervous system. Such a cell could be used in the future to reverse Parkinson's disease, or ALS. Now, I had excellent job offers from Harvard and good schools in Europe, so why did I choose Tel Aviv University? Well, the answer, like all good answers, is threefold.
First of all, Israel is my home. My family and friends are here. I want to be at Tel Aviv University because I myself studied here, and I believe that here my work can have the greatest impact.
Tel Aviv University is world-class. That's why the highest caliber researchers and students want to be here.
And Tel Aviv is the cultural, financial, and industrial center of Israel, and of course, one of the world's great incubators for high-tech products.
But in spite of all that, Israel has more researchers living in the US than any other country does. If Israel is going to maintain its scientific edge, it has to bring more academics back to continue the research here and give them the very best conditions.
I know what you mean, Yechiel. I came back from NYU to Tel Aviv University to set up my dream lab.
Shalom, Yael.
Shalom.
So how is your Star Wars experiment going?
Well, sometimes it does feel like science fiction. In my nanochemistry laboratory, I'm studying the dynamics of tiny particles and fluids. One of my goals is to develop computer devices that will run on light instead of electricity, much faster than anything available now, and of course, much more energy efficient.
If you want to talk efficiency, you should study communication between cells. I'm trying to answer one of the most important questions in biology. How does a single stem cell decide which cell type to differentiate into during embryo development? Whether to become a heart cell or a liver cell, a neuron, or just a supportive cell. A cell may signal its neighbors, hey, don't turn into neurons, I want to be one. If it has the strongest signal, it will win. Understanding this could lead to groundbreaking medical treatments. And Tel Aviv University will become the winning neuron.
After my postdoc studies in computer science at Carnegie Mellon University, I came back here with my wife and three kids.
I hear your kids complain because their father spends all of his time on Facebook. That's a switch.
Well, not exactly. Social networks have completely transformed the world we live in. Just look at Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and devices like the iPhone. Your personal information is sent all over the web. That's why I'm developing technologies that will help us control computer systems instead of them controlling us.
In my tumor biology lab, I'm researching the connection between cancer cells and their immediate surroundings in the body, and examining the molecular crosstalk at early stages of tumor development. This could lay the ground for new anti-cancer drugs.
That's the kind of innovation we expect from Tel Aviv University. Isn't that right, President Klafter?
Yes, this is what we expect and what our university supporters expect as well. It's actually very simple. The best young faculty want to come to Tel Aviv University, and here at Tel Aviv University, we are very eager to accept them. However, a laboratory can cost more than $1 million.
All over the world, there are brilliant Israeli scientists and scholars, like my friends here, who would continue their research at Tel Aviv University.
If we have the right resources and funding, Israel can't afford to fall behind. Our economy depends on
our ability to lead technological innovation. And the research we're doing here at Tel Aviv University
will benefit everyone in every corner of the world, and also help raise Israel's international stature. So help Tel Aviv University turn brain drain
into brain gain.
Our friends, this is where you can help us. When you invest in our young faculty members, you invest in the best.